Good evening, my dear student. I like to start my first video lecture on theory of automata. Already I have provided you the notes, and in this video lecture I will explain that note so that you don't have any difficulty. We have one constraint is that I cannot take a video for more than 10-12 minutes, because the video file size becomes very high and I get a lot of difficulty to send it to you. So let me tell you very briefly about the fundamentals of regular expression, right? So the first question is, what is a regular expression? A regular expression is any terminal. For example, 0 is a regular expression, 1 is a regular expression, 0 plus 1, that is 0 or 1, is a regular expression, 0 concatenation 1, that is 0, 1, is a regular expression, null is a regular expression, okay, 0 star is a regular expression. What is the meaning of 0 star? This is called Clean's closure or Clean star, as it is already written here. For example, say null 0 0 0, any repetition of 0 including null is called 0 star. That is also a regular expression, and any combination and permutation of these is a regular expression. For example, 0 0 1, for example 0 1 plus 1 1 whole star, for example 0 0 followed by 1 plus 0 1 whole star plus 1, etc., etc. It may be very complex or very simple. Okay, so these are all called regular expression. So what is a regular expression, and give example of regular expression, I think this is clear. What is Clean's closure or Clean star? As I already told you, 0 star, that means any repetition of 0 including null. Now in this regard, I would like to say, for example, a plus, a is a terminal, okay, or suppose 1 plus. What is the meaning of this? 1 plus means any repetition of 1 without null. So basically this is 1 star minus null. So what is that? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, etc., etc. Okay, so this is called plus closure. So now let us see the answer of this question. Explain 1 1 star or 0 plus 1 whole star, etc., etc. Now for example, say 1 1 star, 1 1 star. What is the meaning of 1 1 star? This 1 means only 1, and this 1 star, what is the meaning of this? Any repetition of 1 including null. So 1 followed by, suppose I take it null, I take it null, so 1 followed by null, that is equal to 1. Then I suppose it is 1 and 1 star, suppose I take only 1, so it is equal to 1 1. Suppose I take 1 for this 1, I take 1, and 1 star, I take 1 1. So it becomes 1 1 1. So basically it becomes minimum string, it becomes 1. And then for this 1 star, it can have any number of 1. Okay. So 1 1 1 1 1 1, etc. Okay. What is the meaning of 0 plus 1 whole star followed by 0? 0 plus 1 whole star, what I can have? 0 or 1, and then star means again I will come back and again I will take 0 or 1. So for example, I take 0, then next time I come back I'm taking 0, next time I come back I'm taking 1, next time I come back I'm taking 0, next time I come back I'm taking 0, next time I come back I'm taking 1. So basically it is what? any string on 0 and 1. It may be anything. And finally, so this is basically this one, right? And finally followed by this 0. This 0 is mandatory. Remember, this is mandatory. So what will be the minimum possible string out here for this regular expression? This is what I can have minimum here. Null, because this is 0 or 1 and then clean star, means minimum I can have this one, null, right? So it is null followed by 0, that is 0, or 0 followed by 0, that is 0, 0, or 1 followed by 0, that is 1, 0. So this 0 is the mandatory. This is the mandatory. And here I can have 0 or 1, any repetition. So basically, this is 0 plus 1 whole star. That means any string on 0 and 1. Okay. Now the next question is, what is the relation among the regular expression and the finite automata? That is a very important question. So basically, any regular expression can be represented by a finite automata, or on the other hand, we can say that any finite automata must accept a regular expression. Okay, so for example, if I say this one, okay. This is the initial state, I give 0 and I come to Q1. So what is the regular expression? What string I must give so that it goes to the final state? 0. Okay. If it is like this, then 0, or I can give a 1. So this is 0 plus 1. So see, this is a regular expression. This is a regular expression. So every finite automata must accept a regular expression. Okay. So in Chomsky classification, probably you know that if it is a type 3 language, then it will be accepted by a finite automata. Okay, so like this, here also I can say that every regular expression is accepted by a finite automata, whatever it be. Suppose 0, 0 plus 1 whole star, 0, 0 followed by 1 star plus 0, 1. Suppose this is a complex regular expression. There must exist some finite automata that will accept this regular expression. And that is why what we will learn in this chapter. Okay. So, for example, this one. What regular expression is accepted by this? If I give null, this will be accepted. If I give 1, this will be accepted. If I give 1 and then again 1, this will be accepted. But if I give 0, it will go to some non-accepting state. So what is this? Basically, this is nothing but 1 star. So this finite automata accepts 1 star. So 1 star is the regular expression and this is the finite automata. As I told you, every finite automata will accept a regular expression, or on the other hand, any regular expression must be represented by a finite automata, must be accepted by a finite automata. Okay. So, and these are some identities. Okay. Very, very important identities. You must remember all these identities. Okay. One thing you remember that zero concatenation null that is equal to zero. Okay, but zero plus null that is not equal to zero. That is very important. You must remember it. Okay. Another important thing is that null plus RR star, null plus suppose 00 star. What is the meaning of 00 star? Any repetition of 0, what is the meaning of 0 star? Any repetition of 0 including null. Now if I have this 0, then what it will accept? Any repetition of 0 excluding null, because this 0 is mandatory. Okay, so this is basically what? This is basically 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, etc, etc, plus null. So I am having also null with this. So null plus all these things. So this is basically what? If I see all these things together, this is basically any repetition of 0 including null. So that becomes 0 star. So null plus 0, 0 star, that is nothing but 0 star. So that is the generalized form here. Null plus RR star equal to null plus R star R equal to R star. That is very important. Okay. And another thing is that P plus Q whole star, that is equal to P star Q star whole star. So these are the things that we'll see in the coming classes. Okay. So these are the identities that we will use in the coming assignments. Okay. I will give you this. Okay. So in this class, what I want to, this is a very small class, as I told you, I cannot take more than 12-13 minutes. So these are the regular expression 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 0, 1 or any recursive application of this. Okay. Then we see what is the meaning of this clean star and then plus closer, then some basic regular expression. Okay. And some examples, then the relation between regular expression and a finite automata. Okay, so any regular expression must be accepted by a finite automata. Okay, and then some identities we see, you must remember these identities. Okay, so we cover up to this. In my next lecture video, I will tell you what is Arden's theorem and how we solve the problem using Arden's theorem. Bye bye.